To everyone who does have a question in mind, we hope that you can meet the gentlemen and the ladies in person and ask them your question later on. Truly sorry for that. We do have a lot of information packed today, so we will be moving on to that. As you all know and have been told, this is the 17th edition of the Exchange for Media Conclave. But this year, for the first time, we are taking the conclave down south. It gives me immense pleasure to announce the Exchange for Media Conclave South, scheduled for 1st December in Bengaluru. We have an amazing line of speakers, and the theme is Making Brands Purposeful. The event will devote an entire day to engage brands, agencies, and technologies. So tell your friends, remind yourselves, and we hope to see you at the Exchange for Media Conclave South. Before we move ahead to our next session, I would like all of us to take a look at our partner AVs again, please.
Dainik Jagran, since inception, is more than a mere newspaper, a newspaper beyond news. Great editorial content with balanced view of things. Path-breaking initiatives have been running for years, which actually touch people's lives and indeed the society at large. A newspaper which engages, involves, and lives on. India's most awarded, most read, and the most credible newspaper, with over 100 national and international awards to its credit. Welcome to a new awakening, Dainik Jagran.
I see a little bit of an exodus happening. Might I remind everyone that we will be continuing with our second session. The AV was just that much, so if you do need a little break, please be back soon because we're going to get started with our second session. The topic for this panel discussion is print innovation, the road ahead, and how digital is complementing print. Magazines and newspapers are valuable marketing real estate. Over the years, we have seen some truly remarkable and path-breaking campaigns done on print. How can the print industry ensure that such innovations happen more regularly? From the creative perspective, how does print continue to attract and retain top quality talent and become future ready? Please help me welcome on stage the moderator for this discussion, who is a part of the Impact Top 50 Most Influential Women in Media and Advertising and Marketing. If I may have on stage, Ms. Anita Nayyar, CEO, India and South Asia, Havas Media. Joining her on stage are the panelists, Mr. Anand Chakravarthy, Managing Partner, WAVEMAKER, Mohit Joshi, MD, Havas Media Group, India, Bobby Pawar, Managing Director, Chief Creative Officer, Publicis Worldwide, and Mr. Sandeep, Khosla, CEO, Midday. If you may have all of you on stage and get the second session started, please.
Good afternoon, everybody. Interesting, you've been hearing about women through the first session, and women, the word is coming out of everybody's ears. Proud to be one myself, and very happy to moderate an all-men session today. Yeah. So without much ado, I just want to get on with the session because I'm told that the time is limited, and we would like to cover as much as we can through this. Firstly, Anurag, thanks so much for having print innovation as a topic, because these days when you go for various events, the only thing that is being discussed, and rightfully so, is digital. How is digital impacting? What are the screens doing about it? What is the impact of digital on television? And I don't understand why print is not at the fore, because it continues to be one of the mainline mediums in our country today. I don't think we can close our eyes, in spite of the fact that I understand that the spends on print are going down, but that doesn't mean that the medium is dead. You know, so here we are back on discussion on print innovation. And to me, the dictionary meaning of innovation is something new or different. That new can happen, it can be a new method, it can be a new idea, it can be a new product. So before we get on to the discussion, I just want to ask these gentlemen, do they agree with this definition, and what to them really is the meaning of innovation? So can we start with you, Bobby?
I mean, innovation is something that drifts away from the norm, gets you to see the same thing a little bit differently, right? It's breaks the shackles of the status quo and does something that has been done before. It's quite simple. It may be small, it may be big. The only thing that's common between all of those things is that it's different.
I think, while building on what Bobby is saying, I think innovation is a bit like insight. It's about seeing what everybody else is seeing, but doing something different that delights and engages a consumer. And anything that does that, to my mind, is innovation.
Mohit?
I think innovation is something that brings the mojo back into the brand. So, you know, that's something that the brand misses. So, it should be something which the consumers connect with, love, and most importantly, it should be something which is meaningful for the consumers.
So, Sandeep, you guys come back to the agencies to say, look at this innovation that I have for you. So, right. What to you is innovation?
So I think it's with all other mediums coming up, it was very imperative that print keeps on innovating regularly. And that's what's happening. Now, as we go along, perhaps in the session, I'll be able to point out some of the innovations which the print media has been doing continuously. One of the oldest mediums, yet it is being surviving all the onslaughts of other mediums.
So if we look at the panel, so we have the creator here, and we have the planners there, and we have the executor there, right? If you look at it from that perspective. So coming back to the question of creation, Bobby, you guys get client briefs, yeah? And that's when you understand what the objective is and how you want to go about creating a campaign, conceptualizing a campaign. How much of that is the mind space of yours attuned towards print? Because you will agree that, you know, when you create anything, a campaign, for example, you know, for different mediums, the treatment is very different.
You know what? I think it starts not just with what you want to do with it, but it starts with what the objective for that medium is. Most of the briefs that come in for print these days are pretty banal, right? The one they offer up there, just like quick down and dirty medium, that's sort of like, let's hit them hard, straight on the head with an offer or something of that sort. Or if it's real estate, tell them, hey, this is the place, some pithy line about the lifestyle and all that, and this is how much it costs. The whole point is that if you set higher goals for yourself for any medium, you'll do much better at it. For example, you know, since its launch, Volkswagen done a lot of commercials, but one of the things that is still recalled to this date is a print ad, which is the talking newspaper, which was done maybe 7-8 years ago, right? So despite all the great spots I did on this thing, that's the one thing that people... So if you set goals for yourself as marketing goals that are different for print, you can achieve great things. But just what do you want out of it?
So interesting to know that, you know, a blurb on a print ad can pass off as innovation in print, really, or an offer can pass off as an innovation.
Most of it, I think, is that offers and all that is what the medium has come down to, right? I started life as some 24 years back, like as a proper copywriter. I started life as a print writer, actually starting writing copy on bottle labels and stuff like that. And at that time, the medium was sexy. You know, you had reams of body copy. Now, everybody says nobody reads, right? And the truth lies somewhere in between, because, yeah, people don't want to read your ads. The thing is, can you make them? And the great ads always do make people read.
So, you know, interestingly, I think these days, specifically to do with print innovations, formats get passed on or confused as innovations. You know, so three jackets in the Times of India or in Jagran or in Midday, wow, innovation, the client did an innovation. What was it? A jacket on a jacket on a jacket. So that's what innovation is all about. So do you think, Anand, for example, that innovations today are only occasion-led and they are only restricted to formats?
So I think, going back to the discussion of what is innovation, I think the fact is that why do we need to innovate? Do we need to innovate for the sake of innovation? So the agency team says we did everything right, we tick marked on innovation. Is it important for the marketing team to say, look, we did innovation in this campaign? I think if we step back, why do you need innovation? I think would be the first question. You need innovation because it's getting tougher to reach out and engage an audience. I think when it comes to print innovation or any kind of innovation, the reality is this, and at the risk of pissing off some of my clients, the fact is that when a category, when a marketing person is briefing the creative agency, you start with the creative brief. And you are not even considering the media mix at that point of time. Let's look at automotive or two-wheeler as a category. Print is hugely important to auto and two-wheeler because time and time again it has been proven that print ads do drive inquiries in the dealer outlet. But the reality is that the media agency builds the plan much after the creative work has already started. If print is so important for the category, then shouldn't the brief start off by saying that I need a very effective print campaign and let the creative agency start thinking of, okay, here are the 5 newspapers we're taking, what can I do to really capture the attention of audiences? And I won't call it innovation, I will call it capturing the attention effectively. So I think there's a lot to be said about, jackets has become a norm, right? If you don't have, to my mind, if you don't have a great creative, you're saying, okay, just increase the size of the ad. So let's take a big size, maybe people will notice it. And that seems to be the a challenge where more and more brands are doing that. I think if we approach innovation as a need to engage consumers and make it a core part of your brief, right at the beginning of developing any kind of marketing program, I think then it starts becoming more powerful and more meaningful, irrespective of the medium, whether it's print, whether it's TV, whether it's out of form.
So Sandeep, do you agree with what Anand is saying? Because when you guys go back to the agencies or to brands, and go offer them innovations, apart from the fact that innovation is equal to premium in terms of costs, apart from that fact, the thinking that goes behind the innovation that you offer brands as solutions, does that kind of gel with what Anand is saying in terms of, engagement or in terms of really, ideating that for the consumer?
So we do, and this is an excellent platform thanks to Exchange for Media and Jagran, it gives a product like Midday to showcase what innovations have been done to everyone. And, I was the last one to miss such an opportunity. So look at the couple of innovations we've done. So this is an innovation which, let's say, nobody else has done, where we had a 200-page issue. We went and spoke to Shivai, which was releasing at that point of time, and had each and every copy of Midday put into this. Apart from that, a specific innovation I would like to show, which no other medium can do, because as far as sampling is concerned, you can only do it in print. Now, this is an activity which we did for HUL recently, about a month back. They wanted to launch soup, which was aimed at office goers. Typically, they believe that at 5 o'clock is the time where people feel hungry. So rather than go for vada pav or any junk food, why not in your office itself have a nod? And the target to us was around 50,000 odd office goers. So they wanted this to be delivered at the desk of 50,000 people. And this was only something which print could do, because we're the only ones with our vendors who can actually enter offices. As you know, most offices today don't allow people to enter. So this was an innovation done where we had Midday, where we had a nor soup. We went in to these offices, had photographs clicked, and this entire sampling exercise was done. This was highly appreciated by a client because each of the 50,000 was relayed back to them. Now, this was a complete ROI which they could calculate, they could sample their product. And an innovation like this, once you start doing it, then it starts lending a lot of weight to the product which you are out to do. And it gets away from plain advertising. I know what you mean by jacket upon jacket. So jackets at one point of time was an innovation. Once you keep on doing it, it becomes a part of a regular. So you keep on needing, you need to keep on innovating every now and then. Jagran does a lot of these. There was fragrance which was added to the newspaper. a lot of broadsheets do innovations almost on a regular basis.
So Mohit, coming back to again the examples that Sandeep is giving, to you, what is innovation is what you've explained. But how have you, gone ahead with your clients to actually find such solutions which really engage with the consumer or bring the brand top of mind, or whatever objective the brand has set for itself for that particular innovation?
One thing that I did not mention at that point in time, and which is very important when we talk about innovations, is that they have to be new. You know, anything that is new is innovation. And if it is happening again, then obviously it becomes something that has already happened and it is not an innovation anymore. And while, you were, I think, Anita, you said that innovation today is equal to large cost. Innovation today on print specifically is also equal to one day impact, right? That's something that we should change, because if innovation is only going to be that one day impact, then we'll not have too many innovations in print, because you know the cost will always overbear the possibility of having it for a longer period of time. So innovations should actually be something which are more sustainable, and they need not be costly. And I'll give you a couple of examples where we as an agency have tried to do these, and they've not been costly, but they have been maintained over a period of time. The first time was when Times of India changed its logo for the first time for one of our brands. Today it's become a norm, and they are earning a huge revenue out of it. But the first time happened for MTS, when MTS launched in India, the O of Times of India was changed into the MTS logo. But that was not just one day affair. If it was a one-day affair, that would not have been sustainable. Whenever MTS launched in any market in 2009, as it went across markets, we did the same thing with Times of India in those specific markets. Now, that's sustainability. That's impact as well as sustainability. Another example, which is absolutely low cost, but very relevant. We have a client called Quicker, which is talking about, used cars. And you have, you were mentioning that auto as a category is absolutely, for auto as a category, print is absolutely relevant. A simple thing we did was, we asked our partners to place our Quicker car ads just below or above the print, the car ad. Now that is also, in my view, an innovation, because what it delivered to the client was a larger recall for that particular brand, and it was hardly costly. So my point is that innovation, when we go with innovations to the client, most of the time we go with a high cost, one day affair on print, and that's why they just get sidelined. No, we don't have that kind of money. Let's just go with regular standard formats. If we think about something which is more engaging, involving, and more sustainable, I think we'll do a better job at it.
Also, I just want to add one thing, right? I think maybe innovation is the wrong thing. I don't think anybody kind of needs innovation in print, right? Okay, but what we need to think about is meaningful innovation, right? Does this any innovation deliver value not to the medium, not to the brand and the marketer, but to the reader, right? If it doesn't move them emotionally or do something for them physically, then you shouldn't be doing it at all. You're just like sort of pleasuring yourself, which might be fun, but eventually pointless.
So any examples of such meaningful print innovations that you've done?
Like the talking newspaper, we did that and a long time back. It was surprising to people. I mean, the police commissioner of Mumbai sent out a warning that there's not a bomb in the newspaper exactly. And this thing. So it caught the attention of people, right? When Apple launched the iPad, they this thing repeated the front page of the Time magazine on the back page, right? The exact of that and the thing. So those things, right, actually sort of surprise and move people, because they start with people first and not innovation first.
Yeah, I think that's interesting, because it's always people first, because those are the guys you're talking to as a medium. So that's a point well made. Also, the core of print as a product is really to disseminate news, right? Now, if you look at the way news is being consumed today, it's being more consumed, on the screens, in everybody's hands. consumption of news on screens is also reading, by the way, you know. So it's just the format that has changed. So it's not as though you're not reading. You are reading, and the format in which you're reading has really changed. There's a big challenge, and I find that from a lot of advertisers coming back to say, you know what, we are targeting the millennials, and the millennials are only there on their cell phones. They are not there, they don't read the newspapers, they hardly watch television. I mean, thanks to Netflix and Amazon Prime and everything else that is there, they just watch everything on this handset in their hands. So that, to my mind, is actually a challenge for print as a medium. So how do you think today print is really gearing up, you know, to connect with the audiences, which are also essentially a lot of millennials there, and also the fact that since the whole ecosystem is changing, where again I'm leading print back to digital to say, how is digital really complementing print, or print complementing digital? So Sandeep, your point of view on that?
So you know, I completely disagree with you.
Great.
I think print was there, print is here, print is there to stay.
But I never said print is dead,
by the way. So I'm coming to that. I'm saying it is still the most authentic media you would come across. For incredibility, nobody believes any other medium today. Fortunately for us, television has done enough harm to itself. Every night you believe that the world is coming to an end. You watch any channel. The next day morning you open the newspapers, 99% of the stories are not there. So you open any newspaper, broadsheet or midday, you would find very soothing stories. If, you know, a small mention by a BJP MP on the Agra temple, the television news channel goes berserk, and they will have different sites, and it will have a small mention in the newspapers. The reading time earlier was 29 minutes, around 15, 20 years back. It is dropped down to 27. 10, 12 years down the line, it might come down to 25, which is, I think, more than enough. Secondly, the moment you talk about handheld devices, I think more and more, when we have spoken to people, millennials, I have two of them at home, the moment they get up in the morning, the first thing is the social media. So they would go on to WhatsApp, they would go on to Twitter, they would go on to Facebook, and not as much, unless there is a breaking news which comes in, which is very, very important. Let's say an European match has got over and you want to know what the score or some big development has happened. That's the only thing which is consumed as of today. In India, I believe the content is still the most important one which newspapers are able to give. And as we move along, that would start going into different mediums. If you again see as to 5 years back, perhaps in the top 10 newspaper sites, that's websites, there was hardly any newspaper site. So you had First Post and others who were very prevalent because the newspapers didn't have their act together. Today you will find in the top 10 almost 5 or 6 are the newspapers themselves. Because they've got their act together, they have now realized that it's not print first, but whatever medium needs to come out. So an Indian Express site is one of the most excellent sites today, and if you look at 5 years back, they were nowhere. So innovation is again coming within, where you're saying, my content, how am I going to give it in the best possible medium? Tomorrow, if this the same news has to go on Kindle, perhaps most newspapers will innovate to that as well. So innovation, like the topic, is the game, and most newspaper, the serious players are already geared up. The definitive thing here is that they have to ensure that they remain as neutral as they are today, most of them.
So Anand, what do you think about this? Because, we have that challenge, right? You guys as planners have that challenge of how to really get that adaption from print to digital, or, you know, whatever is being consumed as news or as any content on the digital medium is also available on print. But the consumption of that, because of the ecosystem, is happening more on the screens or on digital, as you may say. So how do you try and bridge that gap and manage that situation?
See, I think firstly, I think it's easy to blame millennials, right? Millennials seems to be the bane of all marketers. The easy guys to blame are millennials. They are lazy. So if you talk to anybody who runs the office, they'll say the millennials are the most lazy, very difficult to engage them. If you talk to a marketer, he says impossible to get their attention. They are who they are. They account for more than 50% of the population in this country. They will always be a massive, and they are a massive audience base. The reality is that mediums, be it print, TV, have to adapt to what they need, right? Their attention span is low. They need bite-sized news bites. I don't see any newspaper creating content like that. you still want long editorial. Yes, we'd love to, you know, get them to educate themselves, but that's not how they are. That's not how they were brought up, you know, and it's most of us adults in the room who actually gave them a mobile phone very early in their life stage. So we are to blame to where they are. And I think we're not seeing enough of that. Now, to my mind, there is product innovation possible if you want to target young people through a newspaper as well. But I don't think we're seeing enough of that. So I think a great example is The Guardian in the UK. So The Guardian is now almost a fully crowd-funded newspaper. And the reason they're crowd-funded is because their editorial policy is about being non-biased and being true to what's happening in the world. And the people who are contributing to The Guardian are not big businesses or rich people. The people who are contributing to The Guardian are young readers in the UK and other parts of the world. So it was an interesting article and a real revelation that a newspaper with obviously a strong online footprint is being run because of contributions from young people around the world. So I think it's easy to say that, you know, millennials are to blame and they don't have an attention span, they are moving to digital, but I think it's possible for newspapers to keep their attention if they innovate in product. So as much as we're talking about innovation in advertising, absolutely, I think innovation in product is extremely essential.
Mohit, your perspective on that?
I somehow disagree slightly with you, you know. There is definitely a shift that's happening from the print, the published print, into the online platforms. However, the question is not whether print will stay or not. I think we discuss a very wrong question. It's whether these brands will stay or not. So I am a Times of India reader from my early days, and I have probably, I must be one of the few, I have stopped reading the physical newspaper, but I read Times of India on the mobile. I read Times of India, I follow Times of India tweets. So if I like the way of you know, of the approach of a particular news publication, then I am following that brand, or that brand is relevant to me and meaningful to me across platforms. And that is not good. So Times of India is still a very important brand for me. It may not be in this form, but it is in this form. So this is a reality. As he was saying, millennials are different, and we see a lot of this transition happening with them, and that's a reality. And you that's said true. That you know, small bites of news, which is why news in shorts is becoming so important, because that's where they start consuming. So I feel that the publishing as a platform will be relevant, because the formats will change, and you will continue to have readers in a new platform, which is more relevant to the consumers or the you know, the people of that particular time.
Bobby, you want to refer to that?
You know, one couple of things, right? Same here. It's been more than 5 years since I've read a physical newspaper, right? I subscribe and follow a lot of
And both of them are not millennials, by the way. Yeah?
Far from it. No, not, okay. The other thing is, you know what? Take 15 years back, there was a brand that was born. It was born out of technology, right? And its own existence has been disrupted by movement of technology and how people use it. It's Facebook. It started with updates. Most of them were text, moved to images, yeah, and now it's video, right? So if it can, technology can disrupt that, we would be kind of not very savvy in thinking that even the published medium won't get disrupted. It will, right? The thing is, people are going to want to read. It's in our nature, because reading gives you something that video doesn't. It lets you digest and mull upon information or views at your own pace. You can come back to it. The other thing it does, it is the fastest thing to produce. You can write it, it's out there in whatever, in 5 minutes, if it takes 5 minutes to write it. And you can control the size of it. So I think it is going to be a mix and match, right? And anybody who has holy cows should be prepared to slaughter them. I might get slaughtered at the end of this session, having said that. But that's the truth.
So great. Just one last question, one-liners from you guys on the fact that what do you think is the road ahead for print innovation? One-liners, quick ones, and I wrap this up.
Follow the people, man. Follow the people. The rest of it is bullshit.
Anand.
Yeah. So I think the truth is, I mean, if you don't think about the consumer at the end, forget about innovation, no advertising will work. So unless you create content, advertising, messaging that is tailor-made to like I said, delight or engage your audience, it's not innovation.
Keep being relevant and keep innovating across formats. So new and newer formats are going to come. Tomorrow there might be a Goggle which has all the information. So Times of India should have the news streaming in over there as well for me.
So I think print is one of the only medium where you can do different innovations which no other medium can do. Like I said, you can clearly do as many touch points as possible. Area-wise, geographical, if you want something to be sampled in a particular locality with a certain kind of people, newspaper are the only one which can do it. When you say that these are very expensive, then you're obviously looking at only a particular kind of innovation, which is large format, glaze, and not really getting into what more can be done. This is a clear example where you can do more at not very, very cost effective. So as long as you keep on doing that, I think.
Sure. Great sales call there for print, Sandeep. Yeah, so let me quickly wrap this up to say that, yeah, we all understand whether it is print innovation or any innovation, really, it has to be something new. There has to be an objective. There has to be, it has to be engaging. There has to be an ROI attached to it. Also, innovation only happens once. The second time, it is no longer an innovation. It's a repeat, yeah? So an innovation is new only when it has that new factor in. Creativity is important, and which is why we have creators like Bobby really doing all types of justice, not only to innovation in print, but across media. Print is here to stay, Sandeep, yeah? So we absolutely agree with you. It's not dying. It has a role to play. I don't think there's any other medium apart from print which gives you a tremendous call to action, because you know, you read and you act, and you keep mulling over television, you keep thinking over your cell phone, but print definitely is call for action. And no better example than automobiles, you know, where people, you know, brands have continued to be, you know, advertisers on that medium. I think content was a great thing that everybody mentioned, that you have to be relevant, you have to change your content, you have to change your product as per the requirement that comes on, and which is relevant not only to the consumers but also to the ecosystem in which we are working. Thank you so much, gentlemen. Thank you for your...
much for that session, and if I may have you on stage for a while longer, I would like to invite Mr. Sriranga K. Sudhakara, MD and founder of Vyoma Technologies, on stage to please felicitate the four gentlemen and the lady, please, after they have their selfie. Yeah, if you sing about it, you end up in the big boss house, so selfie to banti hai. Thank you so much, Mr. Chakravarthy, Mr. Joshi, Mr. Pawar, and Mr. Khosla, and Ms. Nayyar for that session.